In the history of science, ever since the famous trial of Galileo, it has repeatedly been claimed that scientific truths cannot be reconciled with the religious interpretations of the world. Although I am now convinced that scientific truth is unassailable in its own field, I have never found it possible to dismiss the content of religious thinking as simply part of an outmoded phase in the consciousness of mankind, a path we shall have to give up from now on. Thus, in the course of my life, I have repeatedly been compelled to ponder on the relationship of these two regions of thought, for I have never been able to doubt the reality of that which they point. Werner Erzsenberg, 1974. Happy Independence Day, Nigeria. Even though we youths in this currently saddening country are fighting our damn government, so keep it on, guys. That's the current slogan for youths in Nigeria at the moment. Welcome to episode 23 of History's Most Influential Humans. Well, if you'd notice, there's actually rain falling in the background, but I decided to just record this episode with the rain because it has a way of like showing originality in moment. So I hope you enjoy it too, despite the disturbance. The powerful and thought-provoking quote I started with is basically the most interesting and captivating text I read about today's most influential human. And to be honest, I feel it's enough to end today's episode. But just so you know a little bit about the life of one of physics' most outstanding contributors, I'll be taking you through a brief history and lifetime of the inventor of matrix mechanics, Werner Erzsenberg. He was born in Würzburg, Germany in December 5, 1901, and his father was a secondary school teacher. And from a young age, he loved philosophy a lot, as he was a big fan of philosophers like Plato. So growing up, he made so many comparisons with philosophy, religion, and science. Werner was from a young age a brilliant boy that loved learning a lot. He attended the Ludwig Maximilian University in Munich and George Augusta University in Göttingen, where he studied physics and mathematics from 1920 to 1923, where he earned his doctorate. In 1927, he published his famous uncertainty principle, which is a bit complicated even for a physics student. Well, that was what he built his philosophy on and what he was best known for. So up until Erzsenberg used matrix, physicists hardly used matrices, as they were considered to belong to the realm of pure mathematics. Thus, in 1932, Erzsenberg won a Nobel Prize in physics for discovering a way to formulate quantum mechanics in terms of matrices, and this was when he was just 31 years old. He also made important contributions to the theories of the hydrodynamics of turbulent flows, the atomic nucleus, ferromagnetism, cosmic rays, and subatomic particles. And he was also instrumental in planning the first West German nuclear reactor at Karlsruhe, together with a research reactor in Munich in 1957. Yeah, I know. These aren't really what most people would concern themselves as achievements they would wish for. But it is paramount for anyone who wants to be influential to strive for as much successes as possible in their particular discipline or niche, because this would be their legacy, their philosophy, and what they would be remembered for. Throughout Erzsenberg's quite short lifetime, he wrote more than 600 original research papers, philosophical essays, and explanations for the general public, which are still used for research up until today, almost 50 years after his death. Erzsenberg met his wife Elisabeth Schumacher at a musical recital in January 1937 and married 4 months later. They had 7 children over the course of 13 years, including twins. Unfortunately, he suffered from cancer of the gallbladder and kidneys and died on April 1st, 1976, and was buried at the famous Munich Waldfriedhof Cemetery in Germany. Well, that's it on today's short episode of History's Most Influential Humans podcast, guys. And as always, I'm your humble host, Damila Imapa. And I hope to see you again next week. Don't forget to keep it on. Peace.